No. I lost traction right there. All right, so it's still an issue.
Thanks for tuning in to another episode of John DZ Adventuring. This episode is gonna suck. If you don't follow me on Instagram or read a lot of my comments on these YouTube videos, then you might not know exactly what happened to my 2015 Forester XT. I did not intend to go this long without releasing a video about my CVT failing. I simply could not muster up the motivation to create this video, as you could imagine. So I'm very sorry it's taken this long, but here I am, and I'm ready to talk. In this video, we're going to go over why I think my CVT failed, what I think you could do to prolong the life of your CVT, and realistically, how long you could expect your CVT to last. By the way, we are only talking about the Subaru Lineartronic CVT. Now, before we get into all that, I want to address the Subaru CVT's main weakness, and that is overcoming really steep obstacles. Now, I'm not bashing the Subaru CVT, I'm simply comparing it to the older 4.8 transmission. While not exactly more reliable, the older transmission is more capable, can handle more torque, and can handle more abuse.
Is your brake on or something? What's going on?
I'm not saying that the Subaru CVT is an incapable transmission. After all, I drove up a level 5 Jeep Trail in my Forester XT. But you need to know that there is a ceiling to the CVT's capabilities. And here is the perfect example. I want you guys to listen in on how the CVT operates.
Yeah. Okay, go right, if you could. Okay, you did it.
That was a lot of spool up time, and the CVT was struggling. Here's my 2019 Honda Passport doing the same hill climb. I pressed down my throttle 5% and intentionally crawled up at 2 miles per hour. Now, that was not a fair comparison, because the Honda Passport has a 20.4:1 crawl ratio. Subaru CVTs will have between a 12:14:1 crawl ratio. But the interesting thing is the 4.8 transmission has just a 12.4 crawl ratio. Despite less aggressive gearing, the 4.8 transmission just climbs better. Here's some footage provided by Daklak Photo. This is a climb up the Oriflame Trail. I did a video here when I first got my Honda Passport, and this is where I actually had to turn back around. It just got too rocky and too steep.
I hate this CVT.
I'm going to keep this video raw so that you can see exactly how the CVT operates going up a steep, rutted, rocky obstacle. Momentum has to be used.
Ooh. No more! No more!
So at this point, Declac Photo needs to go up maybe 5 more feet to complete the sill climb. He's actually stuck here.
Like that?
He's instructed to gas it.
Straight?
With a pedal to the floor, no power.
Yeah, it has no power. It's no power. I got another one.
The white vehicle in front is actually another Forester XT that had similar issues.
Can you check the front for me?
You're fine. Go.
Check the front.
Power. You're right where you need to be. You just need more power.
Yeah.
You're perfect.
Yeah, the line already there.
Yeah, the line is right there. Straight. Don't turn. Go straight. Yeah.
By the way, a Forester XT has 250 horsepower and 258 pounds of torque. Lack of power is not the issue here. So what does Declac Photo have to do? Well, he needs to back all the way down to get a running start and use momentum. I just want to warn you guys, this might not be easy to watch. Viewer discretion is advised. So that's the point I wanted to make, the CVT struggles during steep, difficult, uphill obstacles. The Subarus with a 4-speed automatic transmission did not have these issues. They did not have to use momentum, and they did not struggle. This video is by YouTube channel Machine. This turbocharged Subaru only has a 12.4 crawl ratio, but it has the automatic transmission.
He's gonna do it. Come on. Yes!
Here's a 2018 Subaru Outback with the 3.6 liter H6. The crawl ratio is at 12.8, which is higher than the SH Forester. Note that the Outback is not losing traction. It's simply not getting up without using more momentum.
I got traction boards. They can make bridges.
That's not the issue.
Okay.
The car's just not wanting to
keep up. Yeah.
So all that is going to segue into why I think my CVT failed, how to prolong your CVT, and how long you could expect your CVT to last. So why do I think my CVT failed? Well, there's a number of reasons, but the main reason is because of heat. All that slipping and struggling is going to cause the transmission to get hot. My Subaru Forester is outfitted with a hand-cut Dynapro ATMs, and they're a mountain snowflake tire. They do well in snow, but this snow is hard-packed.
Keep going.
And seriously, Subarus do pretty damn good in snow. Apparently better than a Hummer H2 with a winch. And we can't deny that the driver has a lot to do with how capable a vehicle is. My Subaru even drove up that hill that the Jeep got stuck going down. So in case you're wondering why I had such a hard time getting out of this, it's because the snow was so hard packed.
Keep going.
Listen to the CVT slowly spool up.
The other way. There. Again.
Okay.
out of all the Subaru powertrains, I think the turbocharged engines have the most potential to damage a CVT transmission. They reach peak torque at only 2,000 RPM. If you have a naturally aspirated Subaru, you're much less likely to damage your transmission. Even in low temperature environments, things can still overheat, so you have to be really careful to not misjudge. My Subaru actually never gave me a warning light. Ooh, that was extra abusive right there. So this brings us to the next point. How to prolong your CVT. Well, for one, don't drive like this.
Let my car rest a little bit. I'm still allowed to rest a little bit.
Okay.
I've been like just cutting in the transmission might melt.
Here's an excellent illustration by Hayden Auto, makers of transmission coolers. So I believe the normal operating temperature for a transmission is going to be 188 degrees Fahrenheit. I did a trip to the Carrizo Plains with Dakleck Photo, and we went up a very steep hill. His transmission temperatures hit 240 degrees Fahrenheit. According to Hayden Auto, at 240 degrees, you start getting a physical breakdown of the transmission fluid. If he got to 240 degrees just strolling up a steep hill, imagine what I did in that deep hard-packed snow. I probably got all the way and basically got to 315 degrees Fahrenheit. I wouldn't be surprised. Dakleck Photo got a plate and fin transmission cooler installed. And after running some tests on hills and inclines where he would typically reach 240 degrees Fahrenheit, he's now getting around 180 to 185 degrees Fahrenheit. If you have a turbo Subaru, please, please get a transmission cooler. Save your CVT, don't become a statistic. Now, another way I think you could prolong the life of your CVT is to change out your fluids sooner than later. Take a look at this illustration. At 240 degrees, they recommend that you change out your fluid at 10,000 miles. How accurate is this? Well, Dakleck Photo only has 13,000 miles on his Subaru Forester XT, and his transmission fluid is really dark and needs to be changed. So don't listen to your service advisor when they tell you that you only need to change out your CVT fluid every 90,000 miles, even after you've expressed that you take your Subaru off-road. There's an article by the Metropolitan Garage. They are based out of Alaska, and it basically says, severe service intervals are defined as driving short distances or at below freezing temperatures. Driving off-road will definitely fall under that category, probably even more so. Frequently replacing fluid protects the inner workings of a CVT and prevents the wear responsible for a breakdown. They recommend you change out your CVT fluid every 10 to 15,000 miles.
This is weird. We get it. It's a little wet. We're gonna floor it. Losing traction. What the hell? What is that? That's crazy because never had that issue before. Still kind of doing it.
In a 20, here we go, wide open throttle.
Oh shit. I should have showed you what it was doing.
So how long can you expect a Subaru Lineartronic CVT to last? Well, the general consensus is that the turbo models with the first generation TR690 will last about 100,000 miles. The second generation TR580, these are the CVTs found in the base model Subarus, the 2.5 liters and the 2.0 liters, those will last up to, I think, 250,000 miles if you take care of them and if you drive it easy. So what happens if your CVT dies on you? Well, don't worry, Subaru has your back. They will replace it between 10 years or 100,000 miles. And so what if your CVT goes out a second time? Well, you're looking at an $8,000 to $9,000 repair cost. So I really hope you don't end up like this guy. Or this guy. Or more than a handful of Instagram people I follow. I genuinely want anyone that has a Subaru CVT transmission to have it last as long as possible. I want to see you guys out on the trails. Trust me, I did not make this video for fun. I made this video to inform. I hope you all take care. Bye for now. Have fun on those adventures.